Hello, I'm here to do a video on installing a solar panel on a No Boundaries 16.8 trailer. Now, those of you that have been out shopping or bought a trailer or an RV that says solar ready, they're not truly solar ready for panels on the roof. This particular trailer has got a decal in the bathroom, which I'll show it to you here in a little bit. And the decal shows that a control panel for the solar panel goes here, basically. That's all the sticker says. So, you know, when we bought the trailer, I'm talking to the people we bought it from, and they said, oh yeah, you just throw the panel on the roof, and they really couldn't give me a whole lot of information on it. So I contacted the vendor, and I asked them, what is the process of installing the solar panel? I kind of had it figured out already, and I asked him, I said, so is there like wires pre-installed and you just have to pull them through the wall and connect them to the panel, and that's pretty much it? And the vendor said, yes, that's the process. So this is the sticker right here, and that panel you see right there is the panel for your tanks, your monitoring panel, your battery. You check your levels and everything. So right on the other side of this wall, move around here so you can see it, there is a cabinet. And if I open up the door on the cabinet, you'll see, maybe, yep, there we go, that there is no access at all to this panel. If you look behind the drawer and inside, I'll try to get a shot. Let's see if you can see it. You can. There's a bunch of cabling. Right? It goes up and down. Alright, this cabling, I assume, is part of the solar wiring that I'm gonna have to get to. So I've already once removed this access panel and looked behind there and saw a bunch of a roll of wire that is rolled up and hanging from a tie strip in the back of that. This is the panel I went with. It's eco-worthy.com. It's a 100 watt solar panel. This is the second one they sent me. I'll open up the box here and show it to you here in a minute. They sent me another 100 watt and it came damaged, and I'll show it to you here real quick. If you look close, it's actually a glass front and it's completely shattered. So I learned a lesson on this, that you don't want to put a solar panel on your RV where branches and stuff could be hitting it and it could crack it. So they sent it to me free, didn't charge me anything. I haven't opened up the box yet, but I'll show it to you here in a minute. It's not supposed to have glass on it, and I think one of the reasons why the box is smaller, because it didn't come with any of the mounting or any of the wires or anything like that. So let me open it up and I'll give you a peek. So this is the replacement panel. It's pretty nice. It's narrower but longer. So this solar panel came with the S-brackets and a little installation book. It also came with a solar controller, but I'm not going to use that one. I'll show you which one I'm going to use here in a minute. But let's see, I'll move this over real quick and give you a comparison of size. It's the old one. So you can tell a little bit of size difference. It's definitely narrower, but they're both 100 watts. This is the solar controller that came with the solar panel. It is a CMG solar charge controller. This is the second one of these I have had. I had a Vanagon that I installed a solar panel on, and I used this and it worked really well. I really liked it. And actually, when I ordered the solar panel, I saw that this controller came with it and I was kind of excited about it. But something I didn't think about was the wires right here where all the wires connect there. To connect these, you have to drill a hole below this and run the wires below the panel, and so they're exposed. So I decided I wasn't going to go that direction. I've done a few solar projects, so I'll keep the solar controller for something else. But right now, I'm not going to use that. So I went with this ZAMP solar controller. A lot of good reviews on it. I liked the way it was set up. It was easy to read. Display is really good. And the wires are in the back, so you won't have those exposed. You'll have a small hole right in the back underneath here. So, you know, right underneath in there, you'll have a small hole. So you shouldn't see them unless you're down on your hands and knees looking up at it. So I went with this controller, and I think it's going to be a good fit for what I'm doing here. Okay, let's see how well the panel fits. Okay, panel is all mounted. So I've got the cable coming out from the back. Don't have very far to go, really. But I'm gonna have to add some wire. Got enough room for another one or two panels if I decide I need more. So, but I think for right now, we're not doing any extreme off-road camping or any boondocking or whatever you want to call it. So we'll try one panel, see how that goes. If we need to mount another one, that'll be pretty simple. So we'll move on into the inside, and we'll start trying to trace the wires to make sure we're doing the right thing here. Okay, we're going to go ahead and tone it out. We see the wires in the back. I just showed that on the video, and here we go. Okay, that shows us that we do have the same wire from the roof of the trailer. Yeah, we're real careful in taking this off. Okay, hole's cut. My hole's on the right. The factory hole is on the left. I think I've got better talent on cutting holes than the factory does. If you look down inside there, though, you can see the zip ties. Let's see if I can get in there to the cable that I need to get to connect to the panel. We'll give it a shot. Cut the tie strip and unrolled the wires, pulled them through the hole, and there are two pair of wires here. They are independent of each other. They were not connected together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tone them out, find which one goes to the battery and which one goes to the roof, and then install the solar controller. So the scariest part so far is I'm cutting this hole in the wall. Okay, everything's hooked up. You can see that the solar controller is charging. I'm going to try a couple tests and see how long I can leave some stuff on in the trailer, like the refrigerator and some lights and stuff like that, just to see how long the solar panel can keep up with the draw. I've only got one battery, so may increase that. So anyway, hope you liked the video. Hit like if you liked it. Leave any comments. Love to hear from you. Thank you.